In this video, you'll learn about the meaning of transfer earnings and economic rent. We'll then see how changes in the elasticity of the supply and or demand of labor can impact transfer earnings and economic rent. Let's go back to our model of the labor market. I've created a hypothetical worker, Mike. Mike will represent one of the workers who is willing to supply his labor in this labor market. Now, Mike is eager to work and willing to supply his labor at a wage rate of W1. Since he is actually paid W star, he is paid well above the minimum amount he would be willing to work for. In this case, W1 represents his transfer earnings, and the difference between W star and W1 is his economic rent. I'll provide the exact definitions after the next example. Let me illustrate this point a little further. Here's another hypothetical worker, Martha. Martha is willing to offer her labor at a wage rate of W2. However, she is paid above that wage at W star. Now, the excess for Martha is less than the excess for Mike, so her transfer earnings are higher, but her economic rent is lower. Let me specifically define these two terms now, transfer earnings and economic rent. Transfer earnings are the minimum amount labor must be paid in order to keep it in its present use. It is the opportunity cost of labor, or the value of the next best employment opportunity foregone. Transfer earnings are represented in this diagram by the area in red. Economic rent is the amount received by the factor of production labor above the minimum required to supply labor. It is simply the amount earned by labor above transfer earnings. Economic rent is represented by the area shaded in green. Next, we're going to examine how transfer earnings and economic rent change with different elasticities of supply and demand. Consider the market for software engineers. Assuming their demand and supply are relatively inelastic, we can see the impact this has on economic rent and transfer earnings. The more inelastic supply is, the greater the economic rent would be in this example. Similarly, with more elastic supply, the greater transfer earnings would be. Now let's assume the case of an athlete with an exceptionally unique talent in basketball. They would be completely earning economic rent. If they love the sport so much that they'd be willing to play for free, anything they earn above zero would be their economic rent, and they would have zero transfer earnings. Of course, the level of demand plays a significant role in determining just how much they will earn in economic rent. It is this combination of high demand and very limited supply that explains why celebrities, athletes, and other highly sought-after, uniquely talented people earn so much. In the case of perfectly elastic supply, no workers are willing to supply their labor for below the market wage rate, and thus the earnings are completely transfer earnings. They receive no economic rent because the market does not pay above the minimum they would need to supply their labor. By now, you should have a better understanding of the topic. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and let's try and answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.